Hi, my name is Anthony, and this is Saints Keep Trying. Today, we're going to talk about St. Isaac Jogues. Isaac Jogues was a priest in France during the 1600s. At the time, France is colonizing North America, modern-day New York, Canada. Along with that, missionaries and Jesuit missionary priests are coming over to evangelize to the Native Americans who lived here, as well as those who were settling here. And Isaac Jogues was all in. He knew it was going to be a challenge. He knew it was going to be brutal from the stories he heard. And he said, challenge accepted, I'm heading over. So he heads over to North America, to modern day Canada, modern day New York. And he's evangelizing to the Native Americans. He's converting many people, converting many settlers. But the Mohawk Indian tribe at the time was not a big fan of the Jesuit priests who came over. So one day his group, while they were traveling, was captured. He actually got away. He got away and hid in the bushes so they wouldn't see him. But in that moment, he knew the Lord was calling him to evangelize to the captors and the captives. So he actually made himself known, and he was captured by the Mohawk Indians. And what follows is extremely gruesome, because while he was in captivity, he endured extreme torture, extreme starvation, extreme solitude at times, and even had his index fingers mutilated by the Mohawk Native Americans. But even throughout all that suffering, his heroism shined. He saved a woman from a coursing river, swam in, swam out, saved her life. He actually baptized one of the Mohawk Indians, who freed him from further torture. Not to mention being a light and a source of the word of life and truth to the other prisoners, to his captives. And eventually he got rescued. He was brought back to France and welcomed back as a hero. His story is inspiring, but it's rare that most of us will encounter that type of physical suffering the way that Isaac Jogues did during the 1600s in North America. So what does this have to do with us? Well, Isaac Jogues displayed something that we can today too, and that's courage. Because he faced fear back in his day, and we face sometimes just as much fear in our day-to-day lives. But we can still choose to be courageous, like Isaac Jogues was courageous. We can still choose to love radically, love with all we are, the way that Isaac Jogues did. Sometimes it can be tempting to think, oh, someone else will do that instead of me. I don't have to do it. Someone else will take care of those people. Someone else will do that. And we won't act on that call to love. And Isaac Jogues could have thought that as well when he was hiding in the bushes and his friends were being captured. Is someone else will take care of them. Someone else, it doesn't have to be me. I'm safe. I'm hiding. But he knew God was calling him to step out of his safe zone. And his story actually doesn't end with him coming back to France. He actually decided to go back to North America, where he knew it would be extremely brutal, where he knew he might endure the same type of suffering. And while he was there, he was actually martyred for his faith. He was killed with a tomahawk by the Mohawk Native Americans. I would challenge you to look at your day-to-day. Look at those moments where you could be more courageous in the ways you love, in the ways that you can speak truth, even when it's not the popular thing to do. From all of us at Net Ministries, my name is Anthony, and a saint is a sinner who keeps trying.